Hello and welcome to this presentation on your child's curriculum at Cottingham High School. My name is Mr Wardle and I'm an assistant head teacher with responsibility for teaching and learning and also oversight of curriculum and assessment. Over the next few minutes, what I'd hope to do is just to inform you and update you on the way in which your child's curriculum and education at the school will be structured, and hopefully give you an insight into some of the additional opportunities that your child has the option to take part in over the course of their time at the school. I'd like to start by sharing with you our curriculum intent. This is the core set of values and aspirations that we have for our curriculum and the experiences that we offer at Cottingham High School to ensure that all of our students get the best possible experience that they can during their time with us. I'd like you to take the opportunity to just pause and read the intent as set out here, and I'll comment on a few points throughout the remainder of this presentation. Our primary aim of the curriculum in Key Stage 3, that is Year 7 to 9, is to build on the good work done by primary schools prior to students' arrival at Cottingham. The students will follow a variety of subjects to ensure that they get a broad experience in terms of skills, knowledge and understanding throughout the first 3 years of their time at school. At the end of that point, they are then able to opt for certain subjects that they want to study further into Year 10 and 11. But fundamentally, a core academic profile is what's set up in this curriculum. So English, Maths and Science feature heavily, followed by Modern Foreign Languages, Geography and History. We're proud also that all students get the opportunity to study computing for 1 hour a week in Year 7 and 8 and 9, and that allows them to develop the key skills required for further study, but also for workplace as well. All students will take 2 hours of physical education a week, and also study 1 hour of religious education. All of our students in Key Stage 4 will take a GCSE in RE, so the important stepping stones up to that activity and that assessment are set out in the first few years of the study in Year 7, 8 and 9. Midway through Year 9, students are able to select a certain number of subjects that they wish to continue with from the broad range of subjects that they have studied prior to this point. The curriculum from that point onwards in Year 9 is still underpinned by a strong academic core of English, Maths and Science, but it also then becomes more specialised to the interests and the aspirations of each student. We try wherever possible to allow all combinations of subjects to take place, but students fundamentally have three choices. We would suggest that students would take a humanity or a modern foreign language as one of those subjects to maintain the breadth of their curriculum, but we try and encourage students to follow their aspirations and their interests in order to succeed. We sustain the study of RE throughout Key Stage 4 in readiness for an assessment at the end of Year 10, and also students were expected to continue studying PE because it's an important part of their physical and mental well-being. Part of our curriculum intent is not just about the academic side of the curriculum, but also the enrichment side of the curriculum. We want students to enjoy their time at school and experience a wide range of activities that are not necessarily tied to a curriculum or subject area. You can see from some of these images that some of the activities that we have taking place to try and meet our expectations and our intent for extracurricular enhancement and enrichment. For example, we offer a vast array of after-school activities and lunchtime activities to enrich the curriculum that students experience. The sports department, the PE department, have a vast experience and vast range of skills that allow them to offer a wide number of teams and coaching. But also we have activities within school that are based on more academic fields. So for example, music, drama, performing arts, and also in areas such as maths and science and languages where activities can be taken part in. We're also committed to ensuring that students get opportunities as a cohort. Some of the experiences that you can see on screen here are things that all students in a year group will experience within the course of a year. And it's also our intention that all students will experience some enrichment in the form of performance pieces being presented to them, either by visiting local theatres or by having productions come into school. All of the subject areas also offer some enrichment activities, and some of those are appearing on the screen now, so feel free to pause as you go through. These are advertised to students on a weekly basis and are accessible at any time by consulting with the teacher of that department. You can see, for example, here that in art and photography and drama, there's a vast array of things that can be taken up by students outside of their normal classroom time. Technology and also other areas of the school, such as science, also offer equivalent courses and subjects and activities after school. The last sort of point I wanted to emphasise with you was regarding the sequencing of the curriculum. Teachers have worked hard over the last couple of years to try and make sure that the material that we deliver, the skills that we develop, and the knowledge and understanding that we build is done so in a sensible, logical and sequential order. And students are exposed to that through displays and also through conversations and the way in which lessons are set out so that they understand how their new learning is aimed to build on their old learning. So displays such as these are prevalent in classrooms. For students in Year 9, that is a key end point, and that's a point that we have in the intent, a clearly defined end point, and that would be their options process, where they decide where their curriculum is going to go for the remainder of their time at school. For students who are slightly older, then the defined end point will be their end of course assessments, as demonstrated with some successful results here by Year 11 last year, and then also Year 13 coming back to complete and collect their A levels. Finally, we want to ensure that every single student has the opportunity to engage in some cultural capital, to look at the world a bit outside of our walls and our gates and our fields, and engage in some activity and some learning that is not unusual to them. You can see from the menu here that each year we aim to take every single student in that year out to experience an activity that is tied to a curriculum area, but is going to enrich their experience in that area. By providing that opportunity for every single student, we hope that any barriers or obstructions to students who can engage with enrichment activities are removed, and therefore every student has the opportunity to enjoy and experience that fulfilment. In addition to the knowledge and the understanding and the academic side of the curriculum and the enrichment opportunities, it is also important that we give opportunities for students to experience careers education and information and guidance. To do that, we have a variety of different strategies. Firstly, teachers are expected to share how their skills and knowledge and understanding are applied in the workplace in particular career roles and the pathways to those roles. We also have the opportunity on drop-down days, or otherwise known as enrichment days, where students come off their normal timetable and have the opportunity to engage with various different careers-related activities. In some circumstances, this might mean that we have guest speakers come in and deliver presentations on their work and engage students in activities that relate to their work. And equally, we have engaged in employers locally to come in and interview all of our students to give them that experience of selling themselves to a potential employer. That's proved to be really worthwhile for students, although somewhat daunting. In Year 10, at the end of Year 10, all students are expected to take part in some work experience with a local employer, which is arranged by themselves. This gives them a good opportunity to improve their communication skills and also an opportunity to see what the demands of the workplace are like at this stage. Clearly, reading is also a really important way in which students can acquire new information. And here at Cottingham, we really hope that we are delivering on our intent for reading across the curriculum. We have recently refurbished the Learning Resource Centre, which you can see pictured here, which offers a safe and calm environment where students can come down and read in their own time, and equally a space where students can be brought down by their class teachers and engage in some whole class reading. We also encourage reading across the curriculum and enhance that with opportunities to read during reading weeks and also through the course of Word of the Week, whereby we aim to develop students' vocabulary on a weekly basis by adding new words to their vocabulary and embedding them within their classroom practice. We also have Drop Everything and Read that features within the reading weeks three times a year, where we try and promote a love of reading and also add the competitive element to reading to ensure that students log as many hours of reading as they possibly can within that week. We also encourage the reading of whole texts in English to allow students to develop that fondness and detail associated with reading a complete book. Where we feel that students have a limited capacity in terms of vocabulary when they're in the early years of our school, we also have a programme to help support and boost students' vocabulary known as Cottomology, whereby students will take some time to receive intervention whereby they are learned to decode unfamiliar words and develop their vocabulary and improve their ability to apply it across the curriculum. If you're keen to find out more about the specifics of the curriculum that your child is following, for example, what they're studying in term 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 6 within the year, then please navigate to the curriculum area of the school website, and there you'll find the annual plan for year 7, 8, and 9 at this stage. It details across all the subjects the key aims of the topics that are being taught, how they relate to their prior learning, and how they will then link into later learning further on in their school careers. The documents themselves are really aimed at teachers and have been written by teachers for themselves. However, they provide worthy information that parents can benefit from. As time goes on, we will continue to add to these and also add some useful reference materials that you may find helpful when trying to support your child perhaps with homework or associated project work that may arise during the course of the year. Thank you for taking the time to watch this presentation. We hope it gives you a clearer picture of the curriculum that your child will follow and the learning journey we want them to take while staying at our school. If there are any areas of the curriculum that you feel you are still unsure about, or just want to know a little bit more information, then please do not hesitate to get in touch with the school using the contact details below. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.